So we're going to start this off on the initial net language. Place this on the inside, and we're basically going to sew this up to the corner of the point of the angle. And then once we've reached that point of the angle, which is now, I'm going to take that back up, and this has to be exactly the same as the width. So where you'll be going across, it has to be the same as the width. And if we just turn this bit over, we should realize that that is exactly the same. Now I'm going to go at an angle all the way up to the corner, and then I'm going to go back on myself, back to that corner where I started from, and then take the whole of that around, and I'm going to just basically pivot the fabric. And then go up to the next corner. Now reaching the next point of that corner, I'm going to do exactly the same. So that area of that pivot has to be exactly the same. If there is any bit of a difference, then that point will not turn absolutely evenly. So what we've got to do is we've got to make sure that that distance between there and that distance between there is exactly the same. So what you're looking at here is that distance where my finger is to that corner, and that distance from there has to be absolutely the same if we're going to get an absolute good turning. So it's an idea to measure that and to measure this and to measure this and measure that, so that it's absolutely perfectly formed. Again, what we're going to do is where we've created that V effect, we're going to come back on ourselves and come back to the corner that we started at, and then turn the whole of that fabric around and pivot it upwards, because what we've got to do is now go back upwards. Finish off, and then what you want to do is you want to press the whole of this neckline so that it's settled for the next step.